Welcome to week 16 of Soaping 101. This week, we will be learning the faux funnel pour. It is a very easy technique that is perfect for beginner soapers as well as advanced. You really can't get this one wrong. The faux funnel is an abstract design that is all about color. To get the best effect possible, it is important to use colors that will complement each other rather than seem to blend together. With that said, let's get a little refresher from our week 2 lesson on color theory. Take it away, past me.
Artistic color wheel. Complementary colors are placed opposite each other. As you can see with the red, orange, and green, blue, the green and the red, and the yellow, green, and the red, purple. I think you get the idea. When placed next to each other, complements make the other complement brighter, as you can see in the diagram. So how does this apply to soap making? Well, it doesn't if your bar is pure black and white. But if you want your bar to make a statement, color is key.
Okay, present day me back again. Let's briefly look at the color wheel from a different aspect. When one color is blended with white, it becomes a tint. Here you can see the various tints of purple. If we were to add black to the purple, this would be called a shade, a common misused term when speaking of colors. Just think of a window shade blocking out the white light, and it'll be easy to remember then. Okay, back to the purple tints. As beautiful as they are together, this color combination would not be a good fit for a faux funnel pour. Any distinct color definition would be lost. A better alternative would be to use complementary colors, such as orange and blue, and yellow and purple. Shades or tints of complementary colors would be perfect, but today we're only going to use the brights. So let's get started. I've already mixed my base and I'm beginning to pour it into the cups in 4 equal amounts. I noted the names of the colors for you. They've been mixed with a little bit of olive oil. I get all my pigments and micas from TKB Trading. So after we finish pouring, we'll hit it with a stick blender. I also wanted to add that I've already added my fragrance oil to my soap base. It's an essential oil blend of lemongrass, tangerine, lemon, and pink grapefruit. So you'll continue to mix these until they're incorporated. You don't want to overmix and have a thick batter, and you don't want to undermix and have a too thin of a batter. Just a medium trace will be perfect for this. Be sure to find yourself a fragrance oil or essential oil that doesn't accelerate trace. Okay, we're ready to start our pour. I always keep a spoon in the cup. You want this batter to stay fluid during the process. So we'll pour it in 3 spots. At this point, it doesn't really look like much, but let's come in with a second color. In the third color. See, now it's starting to take shape. And now the blue. Continue to pour in the same spot, right in the center. I'm going to come in with round 2 and pour it in the exact same spots. Thank you. Here's where I switch things up a little bit. Instead of pouring it in the same spots, I'm alternating to three separate spots. And you can do this if you want to, but you don't have to. I think it gives a little bit interest to the soap. It doesn't have to be three spots. It can be two or one or even four. It's just whatever you want to do. This is a very forgiving project. And continue to pour in the same way until your mold is filled up. Your soap probably will get a little thicker on you in the end, but that's okay. Just do the best you can with it. As you can see, my soap really is getting a little thick here now, and thicker soap means more air bubbles. So it's really important to tap it down to get all those air bubbles out, or as many as you can. And that's it for the funnel. I'm going to add a little bit more interest to this, and I'm going to introduce the hanger. So I'll just do a little bit of a hanger swirl. And we'll see what happens. The final bit is to add the leftover soap on top. And then come back in with a skewer and do a little bit of a design. This is optional as well. The faux funnel pour really is an easy technique. No one can get it wrong. As long as you remember to, 1, use a non-accelerating fragrance, 2, keep your soap at a medium trace for as long as possible, and 3, use colors that complement each other. So we'll wrap this up and we'll put it to bed, and let's see what we have in 24 hours. And here's our finished design. A faux funnel pour with a hanger swirl. Hope you liked it. Try it for yourself. Let me know how it turns out. Join us next week when we will be talking about packaging. And if you have any pictures that you want to share with the class, please post them on our Facebook page. Thank you so much for watching. See y'all next week.